Hi, Tracy Hugemeyer here from VintagePreneurUniversity.com, where I help vintage sellers start, grow, and scale their business on Etsy. I also own Rustigai, which is my vintage shop on Etsy that I've had since 2013. And today I want to talk to you about the new announcement that came out yesterday about Etsy's policy with offering free shipping to U.S. buyers. A lot of people are really anxious and nervous and upset and all kinds of other emotions about this change. And it's very, very understandable. This is a big one. But today I'm not going to focus on the psychology of, you know, if it's a good thing to offer free shipping to buyers or not. What I'm going to do instead is focus on what this change means and offer some solutions that you can use to make the decision for your own business, your own Etsy shop. So the first thing I want to recognize is this change is a big deal for everyone, but it's really, I believe, a bigger deal for international sellers who sell to the US. So I am going to spend some time focusing on some solutions for international sellers in this video as well, so stay tuned for that. So what is the change? Let's break it down. Etsy has said that as of July 30th, 2019, so in just a couple weeks, they are going to give priority placement, or they've also used the language, the most visible spots in the search results of US buyers, regardless of where your shop is located, whether your shop is in the US or not in the US, if you do one of two things, okay? So the first thing is if any of your items ship for free to United States buyers, they're going to get that priority placement. Or two, if you offer a free shipping guarantee in your shop. What the free shipping guarantee does is it says that as a shop owner, I guarantee that if you spend $35 in my shop, whether you buy one thing or 10 things, if you are in the US, it is going to ship to you for free. We all know, of course, there's really no such thing as free shipping. Now, Etsy uses the language over and over again that it's up to you, it's your choice. But we all know, of course, that if we don't do this, then potentially our items are not going to be found for US buyers. Now, there are a lot of caveats to that, because remember that the Etsy algorithm is still in play. And you want to make sure that you are up to date on what that algorithm is and how it affects your search engine optimization and all of those things, because it still comes into play. But when Etsy's using words like priority placement and the most visible spots, that to me says that the weight of offering free shipping is pretty high in their overall algorithm. If all of this is sounding a little bit Greek to you, this talk about SEO, search engine optimization, and algorithms, I do have a free training to help you learn all of that. And I will link that in the notes for you. It is my SEO challenge training. But in a nutshell, the Etsy algorithm does two things. It starts with a query match where it looks at things like your titles and tags and attributes, and it says, okay, based on what this person is searching for, let me show them those things in their results. And then it looks at the second component, which is ranking. And ranking has all kinds of things that factor into it, such as your listing quality score and, you know, how relevant something is to what somebody's looking for. And one of those things was if the shipping price is free or if it's low. So if it was low, comparable to other items, then you were going to get a little bit of a boost from that. But if it's free, you get an even bigger boost. So Etsy tells us all these things about their algorithm, but we never truly know how much weight they give to each particular thing. We did know previous to this change that free shipping or a less expensive shipping did play a part. But what's different now is that they are telling us basically that free shipping is going to trump everything else, which is a big deal. But if you completely understand how the Etsy algorithm works, then it might help you better understand what decision to make for your business. One of the things to understand as well is how a buyer goes about searching for an item, kind of the psychology behind how they're looking for an item. So they start off maybe looking for a brown, or we'll say a wood dresser, because they know they want a wood dresser, but they don't know anything else about it. So they type in the search bar, wood dresser. And then as they're searching for everything, and at that point, there's probably a lot of wood dressers on Etsy, right? And we'll just assume that there are. And so a lot of things come up in the search. And then as they are going through the process of figuring out what they want, they're looking at the search results and they see a dresser with purple, you know, handles on it, and they really like that. So the next thing that they type into the search bar is wood dresser with purple handles. And the results in that case are much smaller because at that point they know exactly what they want. Now, you don't want to not be in the first search results, but you definitely want to be in those second results as well. They're both important, but for different reasons. Now let's look at this example with free shipping and what that means. If somebody is searching for a wood dresser, then there are, we'll say, thousands of results for wood dressers, and I'm just making this up, then the ones who offer free shipping as of July 30th are going to show up first, right? Regardless of anything else, they're going to show up first. And you might not be found in that instance if you're not offering free shipping. But if a buyer then decides to search for a wood dresser with purple handles, maybe there are only 10 of those on Etsy. I don't know. This is just a made-up example. In that case, you're going to see 10, all 10 of that are on Etsy, regardless of if they're offering free shipping or not, because there are only 10 spots there, so there's no competition. So that's just one example of what to think about when you are making the decision for your own business on whether to move forward with this or not. Now, Etsy put out a whole bunch of literature to help you make this decision as well. I'm going to link to everything that I've found in the notes for you so that you can easily access it. And I strongly, strongly urge you to read through, you know, once, twice, three times until you completely understand everything that they're saying. So you're not just listening to what I'm telling you, but you're able to make the decision based on all the facts that they've put out. The primary thing that they put out was called The Ultimate Guide to Etsy Shipping. So read that, but there's all kinds of articles that link off of it, and click on every single thing and read it, comprehend it. This is a big decision, so I want you to be able to make the best decision that for your circumstances and your shop. In that guide, Etsy includes 4 myths, which cover a lot of the common concerns that Etsy shop owners are facing. So let's look at the first one. So myth number 1, by offering free shipping, I'll lose money. Nobody is suggesting that you lose money. That would be a ridiculous thing as a business to lose money, right? So Etsy is not suggesting that you lose money, and I'm not suggesting you lose money. Please don't lose money. Let's go back to the 2 ways that you can get priority placement in search under this new policy. One of your items or multiple of your items ship for free to US buyers. Well, you don't want to just go in and change your listing to free shipping. You want to consider how you're going to recoup those costs in your item price. So a few of the things that Etsy suggests is you can look at the farthest away destination, you can look at the closest destination, or you can look at an average destination, and you can calculate the shipping and add it into your item price. If you do the second option, which is the free shipping guarantee, Etsy gives you a tool. Right now it's only available to US buyers, but they I'm sorry, to US sellers, but they are rolling this out to non-US sellers in August. And the tool will actually walk you through if you want to use the furthest away shipping, the closest shipping, or the average shipping, and they'll calculate the average shipping for you. And then they'll show you an example of what that looks like in one of your listings, and you have the flexibility to go back through all your listings and make changes as you're implementing this. So there's a lot of flexibility there for you to make the decision for your business that makes sense if you do implement this. And if you sell a lot of items or a lot of small items like I do, then the $35 order minimum, which is what goes into place if you enact the free shipping guarantee, can actually incentivize multi-item orders because they'll have to buy more to meet the free shipping threshold. So you might not even need to, in those cases, raise your prices because instead you're employing a technique that encourages shoppers to spend more in your shop, which will, of course, help your bottom line. But in all cases, you don't want to lose money. Your strategy needs to be a way to increase your profits and or meet your current profits, but hopefully increase your profits by or with the strategy that you decide to implement. So make sure you read this, and there are some more suggestions in how to price your shipping competitively that you can look through. Like I said, click on all of these and links and read everything that Etsy is offering to help you make your best business decision. Myth number two is that offering free shipping isn't an option because of the types of items I sell. And I really liked that they threw in the "here's looking at you" vintage sectional sofa. There's no debating that it's more challenging for sellers who sell these large bulky items, and maybe even more so large lightweight items that don't really justify a higher shipping cost in a lot of buyers' eyes who don't really understand how it all works. But the point they're trying to make here are there are ways you can do it regardless of what you're selling, and make sure to click on the strategies for shipping challenging items, where you'll see an Etsy video where they help to go through some suggestions on how you can do this for your shop and your business. Myth number three is offering free shipping to US buyers isn't an option because the cost to ship are too high outside of my domestic market. Now, as I mentioned earlier, I already feel that non-US sellers are getting the hardest hit with this. And the reason I feel that way is because yesterday I spent a good amount of time not only researching all of this so that I could best help you, but answering questions and discussing and listening to the issues that non-US sellers are facing, particularly in our free private Facebook group, Etsy Junkies, and I'll link to that in the notes as well so you can check it out. But I heard from a lot of non-US sellers what the challenges were, and I do have some specific things to hopefully help the non-US sellers with that today. But you can take a look at the developing an international shipping strategy that Etsy recommends as well. One concern that I heard from a non-US seller is that the competition is going to be harder now because it's cheaper for a US seller to ship within the United States. But the thing to remember here that hopefully helps ease your mind a little bit if you're thinking that is what you're charging isn't changing, right? It's just how you're presenting those costs. So it always costs you more to ship to a US buyer than it did a US seller to ship to US buyer. But now you're just going to potentially put that cost in the item cost, where a U.S. seller would do that as well. It's just kind of a different presentation. And so the competition isn't changing. It's still there. It's just presented in a different light now. So hopefully things that always helped you get those U.S. seller buyers to buy from you in the past will still help you. The things like that make you stand out as a business, like, you know, your customer service and how established you are, how good your pictures are compared to another seller, how good your item descriptions are. All of these things factor into that final decision of whether that U.S. buyer purchases from you or another shop. And that's not going away. That's still going to be the case. So your competition is still the same. And I urge you and encourage you to still really put your efforts into being a shop that stands out and wowing your customers and providing excellent customer service. And those are the way, that's the way you're going to still get those sales that you always got. Another concern of non-US sellers is that if they increase their item price to incorporate how much it costs to ship to someone in the US, they're going to outprice their local buyers, their domestic buyers, because they're not going to want to pay that insane price that really isn't accurate for them because it doesn't cost that much to ship to them. There's a couple things there. Etsy recommends that you really consider who the majority of your market is and make your business decision based on that. So if you're mostly shipping to the United States, maybe it's not that big of a deal to then worry about those prices to your domestic market. If you mostly sell to your domestic market, then this is maybe something that you don't want to do at all. But the other thing that's a positive here for you, if you're having that concern, is it's already in the works. Etsy's already recognized that it's important for non-US sellers to be able to offer a different price on their item to their domestic partners than they offer to their US buyers. And that tool is in the works, and it's coming hopefully sooner rather than later to help combat that particular issue. So my fingers are crossed for that one coming soon for you. And one more tip that I have, if you happen to be in Canada, Canada offers a service called Chit Chats, and there are a few others that do similar things, but Chit Chats is now integrating with Etsy, and I'll link that for you as well in the notes. But it's in this, it's included in all of these articles for you. And what Chit Chats does is it will take the items across the border for you, cross customs and deal with all that. And they work with USPS to then be able to get the lower rates on shipping within the United States. So I've heard from a lot of Canadian sellers that they're taking advantage of these services. And so I highly urge you to take a look at that if you haven't already. Again, there are several different services that offer this in Canada, but Chit Chats is the one that's integrating with Etsy. They're even offering a $10 credit to get you started. And I looked at Chit Chats because I wanted to be able to help you guys in the best way that I could. And one thing that I discovered is that you can, if you, Chit Chats has particular locations, so you may not be close to one of those locations in order for it to make sense for you to go to them and use the service. However, they do offer a pickup service for remote locations, and they also offer a service where you can have your, you can consolidate your packages and ship them to them, and it still may be a cheaper option for you. So take a look at that. Again, I'm going to link to that. Myth number four is my buyers don't understand what free shipping means. And this is just going into how while you may view the product price and shipping price as two distinct costs, many of your potential customers don't. Instead, they look at it more holistically when shopping online, and it's not really something that you should concern yourself with too much. Instead, if you want to do it, experiment with it. Remember, you can either choose not to do this and see how that goes for you and decide to do it later, or you can decide to do it and then decide that it's not going well for you and turn it off. So you're in complete control of turning this on and off at any time. Okay, a few more things before we wrap this up. Etsy held a Q&A where people ask all kinds of questions and they answer some of the most common ones. And one of the ones that I pulled out of there for you, and I'll link to the Q&A so you can go through and read through everything. There's probably more added as we speak, but one of the questions were, what about returns? Completely valid question, because if you're not charging a shipping charge, then how, and someone wants to return something, then how do you say to them, I'm going to refund the price of the item, but not the shipping? Well, it all comes down to being really clear about your policies and how you want to handle it. Again, it's a decision, a business decision that you need to make for your shop, but you can either decide to eat the costs. I know with myself, I very rarely have returns, so it's worth it for me to not even worry about the cases where I do have a return, because they're so few and far between. But you might decide to charge a restocking fee, and that's perfectly fine too. You just want to make sure whatever you do that you're very clear in your policies. Another question was, well, what about my promoted listings? What's going to happen to them if I don't offer free shipping? Well, the answer was nothing's going to happen to them. Nothing's going to change with promoted listings. So even if you don't offer free shipping, your placement will not be hampered with, or you will not be pushed back in promoted listings. But as Etsy pointed out, the one thing to take into consideration, if you're doing promoted listings, your competition might be a little higher when it comes to other people in the promoted listing spots who might be offering free shipping. So just something to consider, but hopefully that puts your mind at ease if you do use promoted listings, but you do not want to implement free shipping in your shop. And the last question that I wanted to touch on is, someone asked, well, what if somebody wants to get priority shipping? They want to upgrade their shipping method. Can they still do that? And the answer was yes. If you're offering a free shipping guarantee in your shop, you can still offer shipping upgrades, and someone can still select an upgrade and pay for that if they want to. So that isn't changing. Okay, I know that this was a lot of information to get through, but hopefully you feel a little bit better prepared and informed to make your business decision, but don't do it yet until you go through all of the links that I'm including for you. Read everything Etsy gave you, because they gave you a lot of information that is going to help you make your decision. You have to do what's right for your business. And we all have different businesses and business models. And bottom line is, you got to keep your profits. So don't let your profits slide or increase them. Use this as a strategic way to increase your profits if you can. You've got this. I'm there for you. If you have any questions, hop on over to our Etsy Junkies group, where there's a whole bunch of really talented Etsy vintage sellers who help each other out all the time. And we'd love to have you join us. If you're still trying to figure out what is SEO, search engine optimization, and what is this Etsy algorithm, make sure to take my free SEO challenge that I'm linking for you. And thanks so much for joining me today. And we'll talk soon. Thanks. Bye.